Hello friends, in this video we are going to see one of the application of PLL, that is nothing but FSK demodulator. How the block diagram of the FSK demodulator looks and how it operates in order to produce the demodulated FSK signal at the output. So let's begin with the topic. PLL is basically a closed loop system. In this system, it locks the output frequency and phase to the input frequency and phase. PLL can be used in the number of applications, like it is used for the demodulation purpose, it is used for modulation of AM and FM signal and many more. One of the application of PLL IC565 is nothing but the FSK demodulation. The PLL IC565 is available as a 14-pin DIP package and it consists of two input signal. It provides VCO as output signal. It provides voltage at the output of VCO and other signals. Now let's see how PLL can be used to perform FSK demodulation. FSK is a technique that is nothing but the frequency shifting key. The FSK technique is used in the application like computer peripherals and communication system. In communication system, the frequency is shifted either to FH or FL depending upon what type of data is to be transmitted. That means the data, if it is 1, then the transmitter transmit or shift the frequency to FH. And if the transmitter wants to send 0, then it will shift the frequency to FL. Now let's see how the FSK is get demodulated by using PLL IC565. For that, let's first have a look of the circuit diagram or a block diagram. Now from the block diagram, we will come to know that here, the input is applied to pin number 2 by using a capacitor C2. That means a capacitive coupling is used. The basic function of capacitor is nothing to be act as a filter. So here, the DC component present in the FSK carrier frequency are get blocked by using a capacitor. As the FSK frequency is applied to the pin number 2, the loop gate locks and the VCO starts tracking input frequency between FH and FL. And VCO starts tracking input frequency between FH and FL. The corresponding DC shift will be provided at the output. The 3-stage RC low-pass filter is basically used to remove the DC component or low component which are present in the carrier frequency of the input signal. The resistor R1 and capacitor C1 are basically used to determine the free-running frequency of the VCO. The free-running frequency of VCO is denoted by F0. So, in order to obtain the value of FH, which is higher than free running frequency of VCO, the control voltage for VCO is given as VCO1 is equals to FH minus FO upon K, where FO is the free running frequency of VCO and K is voltage to frequency transfer coefficient. Now, similar for FL, the VCO2, that means the control voltage for VCO is given as VCO2 is equals to FO minus FL upon K. Now, these frequency are applied or these voltages are get compared internally with the reference voltage. VCO is present internal to the IC565 and the corresponding binary data will be available at the output with the help of the external component. So, this is how the FSK signal is get demodulated. By tracking the input frequency between FH and FL, the VCO can produce the two control voltages, VCO1 and VCO2, which are compared with the reference voltage and obtain the digital signal at the output. So this is how the FSK signal is demodulated by using PLL IC565. So I hope you understand the FSK demodulation by using IC565. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.